Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of XCOM Anyway Within with the Peach and Porn Squad. And in the last couple of episodes, we were attacking the alien base, which we successfully did, and we got the hyperwave relay, which is a new piece of technology to research, and a new type of sectoid where it's got sort of mind control, sort of psionic attacks, so that's something else we also need to research and put into play with our own troops to continue the game. So basically, we need to wait till we can research those things, and we're actually currently researching a skeleton suit, which is going to be a big help for us, but we've got to wait till that finishes before we do anything else. And there's not an awful lot of things to do right now. I mean, basically we should just continue on like normal until either those get done or we get another mission. Things are looking pretty good on the global sort of panic scale. Since we took down the alien base, like Mexico is pretty high. We already lost Russia, so that's not so good. On the Exalt front, we can attempt a raid on the Exalt HQ, but we haven't really narrowed it down to enough countries yet. I was thinking of accusing Russia, but I don't know. I think we've only done like 3 Exalt missions, and I think we could do more Exalt missions and have that running at the same time to keep the game going. I don't really want to end the Exalt stuff too quickly if we can really do that. So what we do know is that the Exalt base is not in China, it's not in South Africa, and it's not in an island country, which I think basically narrows it down to it's not in Australia, it's not in Japan, and it's not in the UK. I think that they're what count as island countries, which we already kind of know because there's an Exalt next to Australia, there's an Exalt next to, there's a little cross Exalt symbol next to United Kingdom, and with Japan there's a little one next to Japan as well, so we already sort of know that. But as we do more and more of these missions, we'll narrow it down. Now we don't have enough cash for a sweep at this point, and rather than force that, seeing as we've already done a couple this month, I figure we'll just go to mission control, wait for the month to run out, and then we can get our cash and get our counter report and finish all the rest of these things. So we'll go from there, I think. So let's go to mission control and spend time on. Okay, good stuff. So we've got our satellite uplink, which is what we're sort of waiting for, so we could do these extra satellites. Which we could actually do now, but there's no real point in doing the satellites now other than to provide coverage. Like, there's no point in reducing down the panic, because there is no panic to reduce down right now. So I'm probably just going to hang on to them until things get a little bit more tricky. We've also got a couple of excavations going on. We're building another laboratory to help out with the research. But other than that, we're looking pretty good. We do have some more steam here, so I'm probably going to build another thermo generator there and get rid of these power generators if we need to. So yeah, and maybe a satellite nexus, but I don't want to rush into those things just yet. Alright, I think we'll go back to mission control and spin on and wait either for the counter report, the skeleton suit, or... Well, yeah, counter report and skeleton suit, that's kind of what we're waiting for. Okay, they're all happy, we've got a grey day, we've got extra money, we've got extra scientists, we've got extra engineers, alien base eliminated, UFO shot down 1, terror mission stopped 1, abduction mission stopped 2, research projects completed 8, UFO raided 2. Fantastic. So, we haven't got any bonuses other than all in, have we? I don't think. No, all in, okay. Right, let's just carry on then, and get the skeleton suit. There we go. All right, let's get this stuff done then. We will get skeleton suits sorted out right now. Skeleton suits, our first attempt at combining medium weight body armor with an integrated grappling hook for scaling objects in the field. That's pretty cool. Nice one. Okay. So what do we got next? We've got light plasma rifle, that's 11 days. We've got heavy lasers, that's 6 days. We've got UFA power source, that's 5 days. And then we got the hyperwave relay, which is 6. And sectoid, which is 2. Let's do the sectoid and get that right out of the way. Okay, so that's got a couple of days to go. So I think we'll leave that. We've got our money now, which is fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Let's go to facilities. Let's immediately build another thermo generator. And we also need to go to build biotomes and check out this armor. What have we got? We've got carapace there and skeleton suit there. Okay, so it doesn't actually say anything about the information. Like, we don't know what we're building, whether it's actually better or not. But you know what? Let's build some of these. What we've got? We've got a team of 6 right now. Let's do that. There we go. Right. Go to our soldiers, and let's change the armor then.
With the addition of a grappling hook, our soldiers should have an easier time gaining a higher vantage point on the field.
Okay, good stuff. So, we'll see skeleton suit. That gives us health bonus 3, grappling hook, medium armor. Okay. Okay, so the difference between the skeleton suit is we've got HP plus 3, defense plus 10, so it gives us extra defense. The carapace armor gives us another point of health, which has actually saved our ass a couple of times, to be honest with you, and no defense bonus. So I guess this just depends on whether we want to use the skeleton suit or not. I'm kind of thinking I'm going to stick with the carapace armor, to be honest with you. Like, I don't think the skeleton suit really gives us all that extra stuff other than the defense, so I don't know, let's stick with the carapace armor for now. We'll maybe have a look at it later on. Okay, so I think we'll go back to mission control and we'll wait a couple of days to get this autopsy done. There we go. Right, so we can now build Cyanic Labs, a mimic beacon, and neural feedback available in Gene Lab. Okay, so the mimic beacon. This device is programmed to mimic the auditory cues the invaders appear to use in the field. It can be used to attract their attention to the area. That's pretty cool. That could be kind of handy. Rather than us go looking for them, we could lure them into a trap. Okay, we've got Cyanic Labs. This facility will allow us to discover... we need to do that as well. We'll do that right now, actually. Neural feedback. This causes damage to psi attackers and puts all of their psi attacks on cooldown. Does not reduce the attack's chance of success. Okay, so we're going to research the UFO power source, because that's got fast 5 days, and then we'll do the hyperwave relay after that. So it's a little bit strange just waiting for all this research to finish up, really. We've got all this money and we've got, like, nothing to do with it, so... there's no point in building anything. We could build a mimic beacon, I guess. That's going to replace the grenade. And to be honest with you, we don't use the grenades that much now, to be honest. But yeah, it's worth a thought. Let's have a look at these Cyanic Labs. What do we need for that? 3 power, 200 credits, 20 Illyrium. Yeah, well, we got to do it. We can't complete the game without it, so we better do that. We've got 10 power left. Okay, then. Laboratory, that's still coming online. Thermogenerator is still coming. And I think we're pretty much good to go. We've got a satellite nexus there if we need it. Okay, and let's go to the foundry. I don't know, let's at least do improved medikit right now, because that's fairly cheap. I do feel like we should do one of these at least. Okay. Improved medikit is going to take 14 days. Well, yeah, that takes a long time. That takes a really long time. Okay. So I think we're all good for now. Let's go to mission control and we'll spend time on and see what comes up next. Exalt operation. Here we go. Exalt sabotage has drained 124 credits from our cache servers. The exalt cell is exposed now for now, but we'll soon go into hiding. Oh, of course. Actually, let's go into the situation room. I actually forgot to do an intel scan at the beginning of the month, which is a bit of a pain because now we've lost a bit of money, but at least it wasn't that much, I guess. But still, we should do this covert operation as soon as they've exposed themselves. So let's go do that thing. All right, there's our covert operation guy. He's our pretty regular guy we use for all these sorts of things. So we're going to send him on the mission. To disrupt Exalt Cell in Mexico. So we'll have to go and extract him in about, 3 days or so, I think, is usually the way it goes. Where's the Exalt? Covert operation, there you go, six days, all right. Commander, see what we get next. All right, so we've got our satellite there. Laboratory online. Good stuff, let's just carry on. So we get all this stuff done. A low room generator and the Mech 2 Sentinel. Fantastic. Let's upgrade our mech then. Okay, so we've got our guy. That's good. A low room, we also need to research that. New fighter craft, 8 days. Normal heavy lasers, 5 days. Well, this is all good. This is all really good. Okay, we've got 4 days for the Illyrium. Let's do Illyrium then. I don't want to just go right into the hyperwave relay. We might as well research all this other stuff, which is going to give us some pretty cool stuff. Right, let's upgrade the mech to a Mech 2 Sentinel. So we can turn him basically into a medic or into a grenade launcher. Now, seeing as he doesn't have a grenade launcher right now, let's do that. There you go. Now we've got a grenade launcher. Good stuff. All right, let's spend time on and see what we get. Thermogenerator online. Right, let's just see how much power we got. We got tons of power. We're going to be all good. All right, once again.
Internal systems are shutting down all over HQ. This is Central. Security status red. Repeat.
answer me!
Sir, we're picking up movement near the outer perimeter. Multiple sensors have been tripped. We have a breach!
Hostile forces have infiltrated XCOM headquarters and are moving in with reinforcements. We have to protect the base at all costs. If we don't hold the line here, any hope we had of stopping this invasion will be lost. Delta Section, report. Delta Section, report! Finally. Delta Section, it looks like your emergency generators are back online, and oh, Delta, whatever this attack is, you're right in the crosshairs. We've got perimeter alerts triggering from all sides. It looks like you've got flyers coming through the cavern near the rear guard station. Plus, you've got a whole wall of heat signatures coming down through the vents in the ceiling above you. Whoever breached our internal security locked down the door system separating you from the rest of the base. Once we get the doors open again, we can start sending reinforcements through, but that might take some time. Right now, it looks like the closest alarms being triggered are in the vents above you. Keep an eye out for any indications of movement. Delta Section, you have to hold the line.
Okay, so this is our base defense mission, which is a new thing for enemy within. It was in the original XCOM, and or the original UFO, depending on where you lived, I guess. Yeah, it's gonna be a tough mission. I've done a little bit of research on this. I've not seen a playthrough. I've not read too much about it, but I've been told quite a bit about it by a friend who's played through this already, and it's pretty tricky and relentless. So this should be kind of interesting. I've got a sort of an idea of what's going to happen, but being told what's going to happen and experiencing what's going to happen is two different things. Let's be honest, isn't it? So I think what we're going to do is, I think the best thing we can do, to be honest with you, is just get our guys into some cover.
Moving out.
Oh, not that they weren't in cover already, but get them into some high level cover. I'm gonna try avoid using Overwatch too much because I know what will happen is that we'll put some people in Overwatch.
Running.
And then one of the aliens will appear and they'll all take the same shot at the one guy and it'll be like a sectoid or something. It won't even be anything all that difficult. So I'm gonna take the advantage of dashing and move our guys around as much as possible. And I don't know, I mean, where else are we going to move people, you know? You really can't say. I think these little things here are like the spawn points, the debris that's fallen down. That was one thing I do remember reading.
Going.
So, let's see how we go with this. We've only got a small team to begin with. Yeah, it's right. I was right. That's what they are. They're the spawn points. That's kind of nice to know. I've only got one person with a reaction shot, so that's pretty cool.
It's not carrying a weapon like
that. Got a berserker there.
What could it be doing?
I remember them from the original version. Enemy unknown. They're pretty hardcore. The berserkers are pretty tough. Taking them down is pretty tricky.
Fresh reinforcements standing by, Commander. The bad news is we drained the auxiliary power banks while holding the doors
okay.
open.
It's going to take of course, some time we got to reinforcements as well. At least we got one of our heavies. That's pretty good. So we got one of our normal team here, which I'm pretty happy with.
Solid copy.
So she's flanking this guy. So yeah, let's just take a shot at this guy then. There we go. Where's our next guy? He's got a berserker there. I really can't believe the... Well, you know what? He's probably better off taking a shot from the berserker there, because he, as far as I know, can't jump up. Berserkers can't jump.
I'm losing control of the situation!
Oh, right, okay. He's panicked already. Panicked immediately. Okay. And I got 100% with this sectoid. 94% with them, 100% with the Berserker. Let's go after the Berserker with the headshot and do some serious damage, hopefully. I had no idea that Intimidate was them intimidating. No, it's not the other way around. I thought that was the other way around. I thought they were being intimidated by us shooting them. But I guess not. Right, double tap. Looks like double tap. Let's go again. If we can take this guy out, this would be great. Berserkers are the absolute worst. Alright, Jessica's got a good shot at this guy, good shot at that guy. And those two. So let's go after this muton here. Nice. Excellent. Sam has got that sectoid. That guy and the Berserker. I'm gonna go after the Berserker. Double tap, let's go after the sectoid. Nice, okay. So far, so good. So far, so good. Let's get this guy to take a shot at the muton. It's really a shame that we got these rookies with the bullet weapons. I mean, they're both the best. Really the best they can do is just whittle them down a little bit, but it would be nice to have some... Really would be nice to have some laser weapons on these guys, but I guess that's asking a little bit too much, maybe. Because we got all this here as well, but I know all these aliens seem to be centered around here right now, so.
I'm on the move.
Just gonna move him there, get him to take a shot at this guy. This muton who's flanking. There we go, excellent. So what we've still got? We've still got a berserker here. Gonna come up and take a shot at Sam by the look of it. If he ever feels like it. And well, Chrysalid as well, I almost forgot about the Chrysalid. So Sam's kind of stuck there, we're gonna have to take them out. We've still got a rookie who's panicked. And that's it by the look of it. Okay, for now. For now at least. So 100% on both of these guys. They're both pretty dangerous. Let's come after the Berserker. He's the big guy. He's already got his health sort of whittled down a bit already. Actually, should have double tap as well. I know, Chloe, that wasn't double tap from Chloe. Okay, never mind. What do we got then? Is that Jess? That's what Jess got, right? We've also got Sam there. Let's move Sam right now. To get him out of the way of that guy. You might as well go after the Chrysalid before he does any more damage. Right, two health left on the Chrysalid. Let's see if this rookie can take him out. Yep, there we go. Nice, okay. He's got Meredith with the Berserker. Let's see what we can do. Another shot. Let's take that again. There we go. Okay, three health left on the Berserker. He's going to move again. Right, he can't see anyone. Jess has got a shot there. Let's move Jess up a bit closer. 81%. Let's take that shot. I'm going to put that guy on Overwatch, I think. Seeing as this guy's got a shot, let's at least take it.
Shot did not connect.
Really following some around. Right, Chloe needs to reload, so we haven't really got a choice there. Jess has at least got to shut the Chrysalid, but I think we're going to have to move her up a bit closer. So let's ray on and gun. Let's run and gun.
10-4.
It's a little bit risky here. I think the best we can do... Let's go after the Chrysalid. Seems they can poison. Right, Sam. Alright, so Sam's got to shot the Berserker at 72% for some reason, but got a higher shot the Chrysalid, which is kind of odd to me. I don't fully understand that. Let's move him back here though. We're still going to go after the Berserker. He needs to. He needs to go. There we go. Okay. The melee guys are the worst. They really are. Alright, let's overwatch this guy. We'll overwatch this guy. Meredith needs to reload. I'll overwatch this guy. And this guy.
Airborne hostiles moving on the rear guard station, Commander. I'm not sure the alien ground forces can reach that area. They may be limited to aerial units.
Alright, so what does that mean? That's basically... There we go, that's Chrysalid gun. That's basically we're going to have like the airborne units from the aliens, which are like, what? I guess the floaters? Of course, the cyber discs as well. Okay, so a couple of cyber discs and drones. I'm glad we've got at least one heavy, because that means we've got the heat ammo. That'll come in handy against these. Okay, is that three cyber discs now? And a floater. Alright. So this is what we're looking at now. Barely see anything. Okay. I think we should get our guys to
on your order.
Move up as much as possible to cover this area then.
Roger that.
Can't see anything now though, which is always a little bit worrying.
Order confirmed. Target location.
Solid copy. Moving out. Enemy in sight.
Ah, there we go. Right, so Jester's got a shot at the cyber disc. Not a very good shot, to be honest with you. Let's we should move back down here. There we go. And Sam. Okay, Sam needs to move, but he also needs to reload, so let's reload. There we go. And then this guy, God, he's going to have to move back over here, I think, and then go on Overwatch. Regen health. So they're moving. Yeah, they're moving in. They're moving in. Okay. I was thinking we were gonna have to go get them then.
No contact with target. Enemy units retreating.
That's not a retreat. I got an alien grenade. I really don't like the alien grenades. They are a one-shot kill for our rookies. Okay, so two cyber discs. Got another alien grenade going here. Yep, okay. Where's this one going? That's not good. I do like their alien grenades. And here's the third cyber disc all at the same time. We're going to transform and then alien grenade again, yeah. I don't know, we're going to take a shot at another one of our rookies.
Commander, we've almost got the auxiliary power banks charged and I should be able to get one of the interior blast doors open. I'll send as many reinforcements through as I can before the charge dissipates and the door locks down again.
Okay, so good news is that we've got plenty of people around here ready to take a shot. 45, 65, 65, 65, and 35. Well, let's go after one of the 65s then and just see what we can do. We've got heat ammo. Okay, that was a drone. You see, this is the problem when they're all grouped up, is we really can't tell the difference between them. Alright, let's go after the other one then. At least we've got two shots, so... Okay, well, that's the Cyberdisc gone right away. That was kind of a shock. That's kind of a shock, and the explosion took out some health from another Cyberdisc. Okay, this is not so bad. This is not so bad. We're gonna be alright. We're gonna be alright. Okay, we've got 55 and 75 on this guy. Let's go 75 on this guy. Just knock down the health just a little bit more.
I'm all out.
And we got 35 on this guy, so let's do that. Might as well use the rookies. This is why we got the rookies. So, 100% on that guy. Chloe is kind of out in the open there. But we don't exactly have a lot of other options for cover, and with that all gone there, so that's not so good. Let's go with the 100% guy. And take a headshot as well. Okay, there we go. That's one done. Or rather, another one done. And we've got double tap, so let's go after the other cyber disc.
He's down. Damn it!
Okay, we've got Jesse. We got a shot at the cyber disc, 59%. I'll take that. Okay, and it closed up, so it should help. I got 87% shot at this guy, so we're gonna do a headshot. This should hopefully take care of the cyber disc. Okay, well, we've got double tap, so let's go after, let's try that again.
Bye-bye.
Alright, so we've just got this floater to worry about now then. Hopefully, it's not going to be too much of a pain.
Commander, internal sensors don't show anything moving near the rear guard station. You've got that section under control. We've got more reinforcements awaiting orders, Commander. As soon as the power banks spool up again, I'll send another group through.